Hi guys, Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive. We're in a super top secret location checking out this really cool guitar. This is the new Gibson Theodore Standard. Now, a little bit of backstory on this guitar. You might be looking at this and thinking it's quite un-Gibson, but let me explain to you where this guitar came from. This is a guitar that's been brought out to celebrate Gibson's 130th anniversary, and it's based on a 1957 design that was found on a drawing at the bottom of a drawer done by none other than Gibson head honcho in the golden era, Ted McCarty. Legendary guitar designer, it bears his name, hence Theodore, and it's kind of a precursor to all those slightly more off-the-wall designs that were to follow, like the Explorer and the Flying V and the Modern and all those great designs that I really love. This is kind of the first off-the-wall design of that kind of ilk. It was released as a custom shop model in 2022 and it sold out almost instantly, but this is a Gibson USA model, which is available not just at a slightly more affordable price point, but you can actually get your hands on one of these now. And it is super, super cool. In the intro, you heard me playing with a pretty high gain sound through our Mesa Mark 7. Let's switch to the clean sound on the amp, and we'll do a quick couple of tours of the tones that are available. We'll talk more about the spec in a little bit, but we're going to begin with a tour of the tones set clean. There are only three of them. We have bridge position, both pickups, then the neck position. There are no push pulls, none of that kind of business. We're going to leave everything wide open on the guitar. We'll do the same test again with a crunch sound and then with a lead sound. But first, let's take a listen to the clean sounds that are available. So beautiful clean tones from all three pickup positions. Let's do the same test, but this time with a crunch tone again on our Mesa Mark 7. And finally, the same test, but this time with a high gain lead tone. So now we've heard this guitar played clean and dirty and very, very dirty, let's talk about the specifications, beginning as we always do at the headstock. So starting at the headstock, we have Gibson's, I guess you'd call it the Explorer style headstock. It's the six in a row pattern, not the typical headstock you associate with Gibson, but one of their iconic designs. Looks really super cool in this guitar. I think it would probably also look pretty great with the three aside, but I do like the way this fits on this body style. We also have Grover tuners. I'm going to flip this over, show you the back of the neck where we can see the stamped in serial numbers. We can also get a good look at the back of the neck. Now it's a rosewood capped mahogany neck. It looks a little like Carina, but this is mahogany. It's just a very light colored bit of mahogany, and this is available in antique natural. Other finishes are available too, such as cherry and ebony. It's a slim 60s taper neck with a glued in neck joint, as you'd expect from a Gibson guitar. Flip it back over and show you the front very quickly. So there's the rosewood cap neck. We have 22, I'm going to call them medium jumbo frets. They're quite wide, not super tall, very, very playable. It's what you'd expect from a Gibson neck. It's that Les Paul SG fret profile and board profile along with the single ply cream binding. Looks really, really attractive. Now the body is also mahogany. We don't have the center stripe like the custom models, but it's nice and lightweight. It's kind of a little bit SG-ish in terms of its profile, but maybe a little bit thicker. Lovely rounded body edges. We have, instead of the usual four control layer, we have only two. We have master volume, master tone, a little more simplified. I kind of like that stripped back control layout myself. Orange drop capacitors, 500k pots. We have three-way toggle. The other thing I should mention as well is 57 classic pickups. We have a 57 classic in the neck. We have a 57 classic plus in the bridge. Two pneumatic bridge, everything you'd expect from a really rock solid Gibson guitar. Feels great, finished in nitro, smells fantastic. Smells a little bit like marshmallows. If you've ever got a bit too close to a Gibson instrument and sniffed it, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. It's a lovely smell. Smells nice when it comes out of the case. Really, really cool guitar. I love the tulip style body design. Lots to love here. Now, that's enough of me waxing lyrical about how much I enjoy this guitar. Let's take a listen to it. And we're going to do some more style-specific tone tests here and see how this guitar fares in a few musical situations. And we're going to begin with a super dry hi-fi funk clean. For this, we're going to the middle position. We're going to the clean sound on our Mark 7. The reverb is coming off. We're going to play with a thin pick. Let's take a listen to that now. Next up, let's style a little more compression and fatness in the fat mode on our Mark 7. For this, we're going to go to the neck pickup and see how the Theodore performs with a fat, clean, compressed blues solo voice. Next up, we'll crank up the gain just a little bit on the crunch sound. We're going to go to the bridge pickup and roll the tone control back a little bit to see how, first of all, the tone control affects our tone, but also to see how the Theodore performs with some slide guitar. Next up, we're going to ratchet our way all the way to the top of the gain range for some smooth singing lead tones on the Mark IV mode on our Mark VII. The flat board profile and really well-crowned frets make this guitar super easy to play, and the two pickups are crazy articulate but have a load of character and punch. Let's take a listen to that now.
Thank you.
And last but not least, because we know you're going to ask, we're going to dial up a metal tone. Now, this guitar is obviously, it's not necessarily what you think of when you think about a metal guitar, but Gibson guitars of this stripe have been used in all manner of metal settings. They perform super well, everything from Les Pauls to Explorers, Flying Bees. This guitar can hang in that context really well. Let's dial up a classic crushing metal tone and take a listen. So there you go, guys, that's been a look at the Gibson Theodore Standard. It's a super cool guitar and also a little insight into Gibson's early history. This is a guitar that almost didn't exist. It's come from a drawing that was found at the bottom of a drawer by one of the great guitar designers of all time. It looks super, super cool. And now, because it's available in Gibson USA, you can get your hands on one too. Super impressed with this. Once again, this is the Gibson Theodore Standard. My name is Nick Jennison with Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.